mean, I could be wrong.
Not you, Trooper.
Yeah, me. Yeah, I could be wrong sometimes. What? First of all, poor guy. I almost showed you, but I can't bear to show you because it's disgusting. The dude that, like a maintenance cleanup dude that works here at Treasure Island, is cleaning up a massive amount of puke just outside the elevators. I'm on the verge of puking myself after seeing that. You know what, actually, do you want to see it? Should I go back and show you? I'm just kidding, I'm not gonna show you that. Should I take this? Should I take it with us? Friday night, just arrived at the strip. As you can see, well, you don't know I just arrived, but I did just arrive. You don't know that I parked at Treasure Island, but I did just come from the Treasure Island parking garage, you know that much. I'm gonna have to grab a bite to eat because the only thing I've eaten today is an orange, a banana, and a cinnamon roll. What? Don't tell them that much, Trooper. Too much information right there. I took a look at the Little Richie Chicago hot dog joint menu. They're expensive as hell. Like $14.50 for a friggin' pastrami sandwich? I'm not even saying I wanted a pastrami sandwich. I'm just saying that's how much it costs. The hot dogs are $11.50. What? Tonight, I'm going to see if I have any comps. Why not, right? I'm gonna get some food here either way, but might as well check and see the comp situation. Shout out to Kat and Ross from England. I just ran into them here at the Venetian and they told me they sent me something for mail time and I haven't opened it yet. My bad, Kat and Ross. I will get around to it. It's not perishable though. That's the good news. So I forgot to tell you a new policy at the Venetian Poker Room. I didn't tell you the other day when I first heard it because I forgot. As far as the poker comps go, you know you get $1 an hour now. It used to be two. It's $1 per hour, but if you don't have $10, you can't use it. You have to get in at least $10 in order to get them to print you one at all, which is definitely a negative. I mean, I went to Bellagio last night and got a $4 comp for coffee. So you can't do that at the Venetian. Whatever. I love America. I love private property. I love free enterprise. If they want to decide to do it that way, hey, it's their prerogative. If the games are good, I've told you 1,000 times, I'm here for the game. I'm not here for comps. I'm not here for anything else. I'm here for the game. The game has been good at the Venetian, so that is why I am here. I do like the atmosphere here too, though. Oh, dude had an Iron Maiden shirt on. Up the irons. So I decided to go with a little Panda Express, and you can't forget the chili sauce. Being clever, when I checked my comps, I put my name on the list as a call-in. By the way, I like Panda Express because there are lots of vegetables involved. Automatically, your food is automatically healthier just by including or adding vegetables to it. And I try to go a little on the healthier side. I did not get orange chicken. Orange chicken is fried. It also has sugary sauce all over it. I went with the string bean chicken and teriyaki chicken. Teriyaki chicken's got a sugary sauce too. but at least it's grilled. There's also lots of vegetables involved in the noodles, right? Cabbage, onions, whatnot. So we're gonna talk about something that I like to refer to as distracted poker. So it's kind of like distracted driving, right? Distracted driving, of course, you could die. Distracted poker, you could just lose your whole bankroll. Have you ever heard people complain? And I've probably at least felt this way myself and said things to try to nudge people back into the here and now. Sometimes there are people at the table that are so into their phones or iPads or whatever that they never know that it's their turn to act, right? They slow the game down. But I'm telling you, I was thinking about it the other night, and I don't think I'm ever gonna complain about that again, because why would I want my opponents to pay attention to the game? Whether they're good players or bad players, whatever, the less attention they're paying to the game, the less minute little things that they're picking up on and seeing and hearing and knowing, the better it is for me, right? I was just thinking about this the other night because probably 6 or 7 people at my table, and there's only 9 at the table, were looking at their phones. And listen, I pick up my phone and look at my phone on occasion as well. It might buzz, I might respond to something on Twitter, read a couple of YouTube comments or whatever, but I'm always still splitting my focus with the game. I'm still watching the game. Let me tell you about this player that I played with twice recently. This player comes to the table, earbuds already in ears, sits down and immediately puts the phone on the table, on the rail, with a case that has the little thing that props up, right? And turns on, I'm assuming it's Netflix. I mean, I guess it could be another service. I guess it could be a movie, but it looks like a TV show, right? So this person's watching fucking, you know, CSI or House of Cards or some shit, right? Not only does this player focus on the phone and watch the show instead of paying attention to the game, first of all, let me just give you a side note. This particular player, I can tell that this player thinks that he or she is a good player, that they're a winning player, right? The other day I watched this player, cards were dealt, whole cards were dealt, action comes around. This player looks up from the phone, looks up from the TV show, raises preflop, and eyes go directly back to the phone. Doesn't even pay attention to how anyone is reacting to the raise. Eyes come back off the phone, guess when? When the flop is going out. And of course, this player is looking at the flop, not the other players, not any of the real important information in the game, the least important information in the game, the information that everyone has, the information that everyone shares. That's the least important part of the game, because everybody has it. The information that you need is the information that nobody else has, right? Except for maybe in their own head. And if you have the information that's in someone's head, then you win. That's it. That's the way poker works. At least that's the way poker is supposed to work, and that's the way it works for people who are not just playing cards. I've talked about this before, but the audacity of someone to think that they're a winning player when they don't even pay attention to the game is asinine. So troops, if you're playing poker, just pay attention to the game. You would be surprised at what you pick up. Yo, shout out to Carlos from Atlanta. Nice to meet you. And shout out to Ralph too, because you told Carlos about my videos. Oh yeah, shout out to Rami too. We got another Operation Uptick session in the books. You've heard me say before that it's not smart to disobey the walk and don't walk signs in Vegas because of the patterns that they follow, and because how fucking crazy the cab drivers drive. So when I see people disobeying the signs, in other words, walking when it says don't walk, I think to myself, wow, that's not safe, that's dumb. But when I see them do it and they have little kids with them, I'm like, not only is that fucking stupid, number one, but you're also teaching the kids to be stupid. How do you teach your fucking kids to walk when it says don't walk? To me, that's just irresponsible. Where the hell are social services? Did you figure out that since I'm back at Treasure Island, the session must be over? Oh yeah, it's over. I gotta go home and edit this vlog now, because I'm meeting up with Molly to hang out earlier tomorrow. Yo, where did I go? This camera. Fucking camera. So since the session is over, I know you want to know, Trooper, what's the result? Did you win or lose? Did you progress or regress? Huh? What? In Operation Uptick tonight, we made progress. I won. I won an even number, if you can believe that. Exactly $300. Where the fuck is my... I know where it is. Everybody calm down. Yeah, I parked over here. Okay. There's nobody there. Uh-oh, there's somebody there, though. Oh, shit. There's people over here. Trooper, calm down. People gonna think you crazy. If I'm not mistaken, we're less than $1,000, I think, to Mission 3. From the, how you doing? All right. What? So, from the, where am I at? Treasure Island parking garage. Allow me to remind you that if you like my videos, please do click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss anything. Tell your friends about the videos so they can watch them too. And leave a comment down below. What? Look at all that Vegas. Look at it. Look at all that Vegas we got going. Oh, wow. Shit never gets old. I will see you next time.